Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
You might not find a more immense spectacle in college football. It's game day at Beaver Stadium, and this place is packed. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Peterson from the six, and he's tackled at the 26-yard line. Penn State's coaches admitted to us that they game plan around this guy. It's kind of different for a wide receiver. It's usually a running back or a quarterback, but he's paid off for him so far.
He really has, and I found it very refreshing as we travel around the country and visit with so many of these players to find a high-profile wide receiver who's a selfless guy. He's a great leader from everything that they've told us. He's a guy that wants to go out there and make sure that the team gets the win first before he gets his catches. Kind of a rare breed in today's game of college football, but he's an exceptional player.
First guy on the field and the last guy off at practice. Second and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. And down he goes to the 38-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Andrews was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. Big opening. And he's taken down around the 46-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Stop at the 43-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
With the safeties coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
It's second and six. Ball on the 43. Made right around the 30. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
Brought down at the 31-yard line. Loss of one there for the halfback.
That'll bring up second
and this play is number eight on the drive. He's got the corner. He's brought down in the open field.
Gaining 2 yards.
Kirk will get a player down, obviously in some pain. From the 29-yard line, it's third down. Fires complete over the middle. Not much there on the screen play.
No gain on the play.
The Nittany Lions had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return. Penn State is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and he got it. Meeks ready to kick. Kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Virginia's got a new coach at the helm here in this one, Herbie, and you got to wonder what kind of impact that's going to have. Players people always want to sell out for a new coach, so I expect an emotional game and a lot of big plays. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out. And he's tackled at the 34.
That's a deep number. That brings up second and one.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That makes it first and 10.
Catches it, and that's all.
Game of six on the play. That brings him second and five.
The delay, and he's brought down immediately. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Spence to punt. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Three points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. Penn State is up by three. They'll bring him down at the 43. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Parker on the give. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. Out to about the 45-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it fourth and inches.
Franklin, back to return. Penn State's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, the Nittany Lions with a 3-point lead. We're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled right away.
Number 52 makes the tackle at the 33-yard line. That'll bring up second and three.
At the 44-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
That makes it second and eight.
Four down. Mike 56.
Mike 56. Easy, easy, easy. Rally. Rally.
tackle immediately. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. Taken down behind the line. And this is not good news. This is a very serious injury. Peterson awaiting the return. And down he goes at the 36. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Penn State is up a field goal. He's taken down at about the 37-yard line. Maybe a yard on that draw play. From their own 37-yard line. Second down. He might have a chance. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And down he goes at the 49.
The defense is there to defend the pass, but was still unable to stop them from picking up enough yards to move the chains.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. Play fake, looking to run. He's at the 40. And he's taken down at the 35. From the 35-yard line, first down.
Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier, back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon.
After decent pickup.
That'll bring up second and three.
Penn State has a three-point lead. And he's immediately tackled. From the 25-yard line, it's first down, five wide. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in.
Well, these guys lost a lot of talent to graduation last year. They've got to put some new faces in there. And this guy looks like he's the real thing, and he can help in that area.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Sets them up with a first and goal.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Ready!
Touchdown, Penn State! The extra point. nice nine-play, 65-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drop. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. He gets hit out of bounds around the 33-yard line.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gets his running back, and it's knocked out. Complete. He's got room to work. Fires it out. And they make the stop at around the 48-yard line.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down.
Mike 56, Mike 56. Easy. Eagle.
There's a strike complete. And he's level at the 49-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 49.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage. Can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find the receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. Tackle made at the 36-yard line. Andrews having a tough first two quarters, Kirk, right now. Can't hang his head, though, because he could be very important before this game's all over.
Good point. He's going to have to stay positive. This team's going to need him before this game is over. Right now, this team has the lead. He's not played well. Do not be surprised at all. This team will make some adjustments at halftime. They'll come out shooting again in the second half. And you know he's still going to be involved. And because of his big playability, he could just be one play away from making a game-changing play.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Now he's scrambling. Brought down around the 31-yard line. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23. He scrambled. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he's tackled at the 15.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
And he's got it. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The midshipmen derive ranked number 11 in the country. Check out these two teams keeping it close. The midshipmen have the lead 13-6.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. Penn State's got a 13-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both passing games have struggled in the first half, David, and a lot of times you think of defensive backs being finesse-type athletes. A lot of physicality shown in that first half.
No doubt about it. In defensive backs, the ones that we like the best are the ones that can play on an island and play extremely physical, because most offenses are predicated around timing and rhythm, and you see quarterbacks all the time in seven-on-sevens and all summer getting with their wide receivers to try to get that perfect timing, and if you can jam them up at the line of scrimmage, you can mess up that timing. And doing a good job of that, playing close to the line of scrimmage, you know, not letting those receivers get too much wide open spaces and not giving away those easy completions. It's been a clinic so far the first half.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Nittany Lions continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Quick pass. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He fights forward to about the 30. They'll spread the field with five wide. He's scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 45.
That's a deep five. That brings him second and five.
He's tackled immediately after the catch.
That'll make it third and 13.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. And he's hit immediately.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Makes it first and 10.
Larry, Mike 56, Mike 56. I'm going to run you over. I'm going to run you over.
Red 18, fuck you, fuck you.
He zips it. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
You know, for a safety, this guy has really good hands. I'm very surprised to see him drop an interception like that. Could come back to haunt his team as well.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Gets out to around the 32.
That's a D11 play. First down.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. That'll be a loss of one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
10th play of the drive.
Three down.
quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Crosses to the running back, and he pulls in another one. And he tackles him hard at the 34-yard line.
That makes it 4th and 12.
Spence to punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. He's tackled at the 22. From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. Looking to scramble down, he can't get away from the pressure.
That is a loss of 10 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
First and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Davis gains around 5 yards on the draw play from scrimmage.
That makes it second and 6.
Tackled for a loss.
That's a loss of 6 yards. That makes it 3rd and 11.
So we're looking at another 3rd down here. Was the intended target, and that'll make it 4th down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Franklin back deep to return. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
Down 2 possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Tackle around the 49-yard line. No good. 3rd down, and they need to get it inside the 43. They come out on an empty backfield.
Nine,
get the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
This turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. 13-0, Penn State. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
All right, D, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Peterson is back deep to return the punt. Gets to about the 34-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He lets it go, makes the catch, and gets out of bounds. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. Here's a running play. Nice run there. Davis comes away with 5 yards on the carry. First and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. He's at the 30, gains his way to the 26-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
He's taken down around the 16-yard line. About a 10-yard gain that time on the completion on the slant.
You leave your defenders vulnerable when it's man coverage. And that time, he paid for being a step behind the receiver.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Patriot! Patriot!
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That brings him second and goal.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Him hard at the 2-yard line. Parker gets 3 yards on the carry. Virginia is going to use their first time out of the half here. The defense backed up into their own end zone. It's third and goal from the 1. All the big boys are on the field now. Both teams have their big sets out there. Touchdown, Nittany Lions. The extra point. A quick update now. Here's Reese.
The midshipmen take the field, ranked 11th.
Is this the peak for this team, or can they soar even higher? This is a game we've been watching closely today. And for Navy, they're looking to win two in a row. Navy on top, 27-13.
That's good stuff, Reese. Thank you. Penn State gets set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
They come out in a five-wide set. Just throws this one away. From their own 25-yard line, second down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Here's the halfback on the screen. He tackles him for a loss. And they make the stop, the 39-yard line. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
Man, the defense looked a little sluggish there, and they can do better than that.
First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line.
Mike 56, Mike 56.
Go, D.
Let's go.
Wants to throw outside.
Franklin was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Little toss across the middle. Sanchez gains 4 yards on that reception.
That makes it three to seven.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. 2 yard pickup.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
56, Mike, 56.
He's at the 30, and he's tackled right away.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 28. We have less than a minute to go. Makes the catch, and look out. Tackle made around the 24-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on the play.
Jack, Jack,
make it
Jack, Jack.
Shift, shift.
Caught out in the open. Brought down at the 16-yard line.
Williams makes the tackle at the 16-yard line.
Easy. Eagle! Eagle!
Caught with room to work. And he's tackled right around the 10-yard line.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Buffalo, Buffalo!
Alert three.
And he stops the clock with a spike. And this is the 14th play of the drive. Sacked.
Clemson's performance today, I think nationally, Kirk, is going to take a hit as him being a superstar. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it could hurt him, but at the same time, the team won. He didn't have a great game, but the fact that his team was able to kind of rally and still come up with a win, I still think it helped his cause as far as some of the national recognition.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.